right here because it's input, the influence on available phosphorus. The inputs the way they are, you want to try to maximize what you're getting out of it. Okay, Jason Kerbs, I live in Denver, Colorado right now. Just a little history, I grew up in southern Idaho. Uncle's a farmer, dad's been in fertilizer for 52 years, so it's always been a family thing. Overview, I'll go through the industrial uses, how it fits in the ag market, and all proven and tested, different application methods and raise recommendations. These are just six of the 42 patents we have. Enhance fertilizer uptake, nutrient uptake, enhance herbicide effectiveness, insecticides. It's really a duct tape. It has a lot of different uses. Amisorb is thermal polyaspartate, TPA. You'll see on some of the slides it's listed as TPA. It's an amino acid made from aspartic acid. It's actually non-toxic, biodegradable, safe for drinking water, up to 250 parts per million. And this is a big deal right here. It's a large negative charged ion. And the CEC is 750. That CEC is key because when we attach to the calcium, aluminum, zinc, whatever's in the water or soil, if the plant comes in contact, it releases it. So that CEC is not too tight. The molecular weight is approximately 5,000. So the industrial, this is what it was developed for, is the oil fields. Offshore oil drilling, when they're sucking oil and seawater through miles and miles of pipe, they're getting a calcium or a barium buildup in the pipe. We developed non-toxic biodegradable because in the North Sea, the guys that use it, the BP, the Royal Dutch, the big guys, the number one resource is not the oil, it's the sand. So they can take the molecule and throw it in the ocean and it biodegrades. So we go into car washes, laundry, and dishwasher detergent. Same molecule is sold at Target and Safeway for their dishwasher pellets. Just keeps the white spots off the dishes. Another aspect of the molecule is it's a dispersion, suspension, and anti-redeposition. We sell it to a rug doctor for that reason too. So when you suck the dirt off the carpet, it attaches to it and keeps it in the solution and doesn't redeposit it. Just found out last week, the Italian wine market, they're actually putting it directly into the wine. Keeps the little sediment off the bottom of the bottle. So, and this is key too, it's a humectant, which means it retains water. And we sell it to the hair coloring, shampoo, sunscreens, lotions, just, you know, keeps moisture. So all those relate to the ag market, and I'll go through that. So, industrial scale inhibition. It's a crystal growth inhibitor, delays the formation of precipitants, keeps the positives and negatives from coming together. So here we go, offshore oil. That's what they are doing, you know. And when those guys, as soon as they start getting build up in the pipes, they can tell right away because the pressure goes up so much. The humectant, you can see they treated the hair with and without, let it dry. And you can just see it helps retain moisture. So how do all these fit into the agriculture market? It's the same slide as the industrial, you know. It keeps the precipitants from forming. You know, once your fertilizer bonds with something, you're gonna have to have a bug chew it apart so the plant can take it up. So you put it in with the fertilizer, keeps it from tying up, and just keeps it available longer so the plant has a chance to take it up. So this was the patent work done by Fred Velo, and he put on the nutrients. Low is 20% of normal, and then with and without TPA, you can see on the micros how much more iron we we didn't really affect. Sometimes iron's a little tricky, but you can see, you know, the amount of uptake you get when you just keep everything separate. Same thing, you know, when he was putting on low nutrition, 20%, a lot of that was getting tied up. So that's why without the TPA, just the plant barely got anything. And he raised wheat hydroponically and then had it all ground up and analyzed the whole plant. That's the first thing they noticed when Amisorb came in the market with it, in enhanced root development. So when you have a better root system, you're just going to have more chance to come in contact with the nutrients in the soil. Same thing, 95% probability. So Amisorb's nothing new. My dad brought it into the ag market a little over 20 years ago. We had tons of university conduct research on it. It's not crop specific. Since we treat the water in the soil, it doesn't matter what you plant on. You can see potatoes, 23 trials, average yield, 5,800 weight. Winter wheat, corn, we have trials on it, everything. So University of Wisconsin, 2007, grabbed some fertilizer additives. We didn't have any part in this. We haven't paid for university research in over a decade. They actually went with Avail and Amisorb. And you can see they put the phosphate on at 65 pounds, 130 and 195. You can see the difference in the marketable yields. Tuber size, so it's 135 pounds of phos, increase of 18, and so at 135 pounds of phosphate, significantly higher than Avail. This is the one that's key though. If you look, 65, 130, 195, 65 pounds of TPA, out yielded 195 fertilizer by itself. So it's just showing that you are making that fertilizer work for it. So here, I'll show you guys a demonstration, really, and just show you what it does. And hopefully this works, because I usually don't do it in these big jars, so let's see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put ammonium sulfate fertilizer in here. And then I'll go with the like on foliar, 1 to 2% of volume is what we recommend, so I'll go with the 2% rate, just to be safe, hopefully. And I'm gonna put calcium chloride on top of it. Represents really bad water.
Any of you know with liquid, calcium and sulfur do not like each other. They precipitate out, they'll turn into a white, pretty white mess. So all this done is keep it from finding each other. That's how it works with your phosphorus and stuff in your starter. Iron is a big culprit for tying the phosphorus in the soil. So what it does, it allows the phosphorus to stay available and not get tied up with the iron complex in that happens.
So you just give it a second, you know, the positive and negatives come together. There's nothing you can do about it. Yeah, that. Yeah, go ahead. And yeah, that just shows what it does. So, corn trials, 23 trials, overall average was 9.3 bushel increase. And this just breaks it down, you know, two trials, two quarts of planting, 15 bushels, three trials with one quart, 9 bushel. And then, boy, you know, just read through them. And then this one, yeah, then it, a decrease. But you never know on the university farms, you know, some of those trials, they've been throwing down chemicals and different stuff for the last 50, 75 years. So there's Kansas State, 8 trials, 1 or 2 quarts, 4 trials with 1 quart, 16.5 bushel increase, 4 trials with 2 quarts increase, 28.75 bushel. And that's just a summary. And as far as trials, like I said, we haven't paid for any trials recently. So we're trying to get new data. If anybody wants to try it, talk to your salesman or Tony and we'll work out, we'll reimburse you for some trials depending on, you know, put it out there, prove it to yourself that it works. You know, because I can sit up here all day and tell you what it's done for the last 20 years, but until you guys put it out on your own farm, you're not going to believe it. So, Olmex Canada, so this is deals with the Roundup. So same thing, you know. Last I heard there's, you have to put in 17 pounds of ammonium sulfate with your glyphosate, and that's because the ammonium sulfate's negative and Roundup's negative. They want the ammonium sulfate in there to get tied up and leave the Roundup available. But why Amisorb increased the effect, it's that humectant property. You spray it out there, it's gonna keep that wetter longer. And then with the next wetting, whether it's the dew in the morning, a rainstorm or irrigation, it will pull that moisture. And that's how it increases the effectiveness of the herbicide. So after 12 hours, you can see, and once you get those precipitants, if you can see them, the plant can't take them up. So some people say, hey, can we reduce the amount of fertilizer? So they compared 10 and 20 pounds of phosphate per acre. Amisorb was applied at 0.5 liter. And you can see the increase of root development and the canopy. Same thing. Different 1 quart, 2 quarts. So they said the 10 pounds with the Amisorb is equivalent to 20. Of course, we don't recommend that. You just cut your fertilizer drastically. You know, 20 to 25% would be pushing it. But unless that's what you want to push towards, you might as well just put the Amisorb in with the fertilizer you're already using. You already spend the money on it. You might as well make it work for you. How can it be applied? Well, the number one way is, you know, with the starter, pop-off, cypress, dry or liquid. And this was old. My dad put this in there last time he was out here. I'll come back to that. So this is the foliar patent. What they did is they took navel orange discs from the leaf, soaked them in the spray, and you can see the uptake percent. And this is real low, 2 parts per million or 10 parts per million. And it still has the effect. This is the percent of what iron you're getting into that leaf. So this is, again, so my dad did this slide 10 years ago, and these were the numbers right here. In the last 5 years, it's been put on 9.2 million acres foliarly. So it just increased over the last 10 years especially. So insecticides, same thing. It's keeping it wetter longer. So when you have the insect come and absorb it, this is the malathion killed 100%. Well, 99, because they did see one ant. How long does it last in the soil? It all depends on the bug activity. That's what degradates the molecule. You know, it's aspartic acid. It's sweet, like aspartame, same stuff NutraSweet's made from. So they start breaking it down. So it lasts anywhere between 90 and 110 days, around there. But as you stimulate that bug activity, you know, they're gonna break apart some of the precipitants in the soil and just increase that availability to the plant. So these are on the label in California. California is one of the hardest states to get something labeled in. Enhances nutrient uptake, increased nutrient availability by reducing fertilizer. Ensures better health and seedling growth by keeping the fertilizer phosphate available. Complexes calcium and other nutrients resulting in improved fruit quality. So the rates of recommendation, 1 to 2 quarts per acre. You're going foliar, 1%, 2% of volume. And 3 irrigation systems, 1 pipe, 2 quarts per ton. And if you put through a pivot, it's more, you know, it depends on how much water you're putting out. It's proven, like I said, we've been selling this for the last 20 years. We spent millions of dollars testing it when it first came out. It's non-crop specific.
Close.
Any questions?
Yeah, with the phosphate, you spread it broadcast. Do you recommend putting Amisorb in broadcast phosphate?
Yeah,
that okay. There wasn't anything up there about that, so I didn't know what.
Okay, yeah, sorry.
I was just wondering. Just in the row or whether.
No, it goes on the dry, 3 quarts per ton.
Okay.
Dry product.
Dry. You guys still use it? Yeah. So they do have a dry product that they use. Is that what you put in with the dry? Okay.
Well, Samusor dry, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
The reason with Jason Sam, when you look at a soil test phosphorus, what do you always see? It's usually really high. And it's really high for a reason, because our biggest culprit here is iron. Iron will tie up the phosphorus in the soil and make it unavailable. Iron, aluminum, and calcium are the 3 things that will tie up phosphorus. So if you look at a soil test, you know, phosphorus reading, 5 to 10% of that is all you'll get the whole year. Very minimal. So now you look at a starter, you think, well, okay, I'm going to put a starter, I'm going to give it the phosphorus it needs there. You're only going to get 35 to, at the very most, 40% of that being utilized, the rest will tie up. So it's important to try to get better use of what you're doing. That's the purpose of Amisorb, because it keeps it from tying up, because it complex, or I mean, it coats it, so it can't complex. So when it complexes, it ties up. So what it's doing, in essence, you're having more of your product out there for a longer period of time available to the plant before it actually ties up. So it's almost like putting more on, but you're not. You're getting more pull out of it, you're getting more results from it, because it's like you're putting more product down, but you really didn't do anything. Except made it more available a lot longer.
It's still a bale in there.
Oh, yeah. Everybody's heard of bale. A bale's, I think there's a Sidmon, right?
Well, no, they're owned by Verdesian now. Just a quick thing on that. A bale was developed by our lab, and we said no, because we were developing non-toxic biodegradable. So Larry Sanders took the 2 scientists and started SFP in a bale. And the key on that,
it'll just prevent diet.
The molecular weight is around 5,000. We have everything patented from 1,000 to 100,000 on the size of that molecule. So Avail, Nutrisphere, more than, they're all 800 molecular weight. So their CEC, they do bind to that calcium or aluminum or zinc or whatever is in there. But their CEC is 1750, ours is 750. They bind so tight that they will not release that. They precipitated it out. If I would have, and on my little demo that I did, I do a bale and it does pretty much the same thing the check does. So that's the difference between the two. In fact, you know,
they've been promoting very heavily over the years.
Right. Yeah.
So you hear about a bale quite often.